on the table. Welcome back. This is Jason Glatzer live at Card Casino for the Norwegian Championship. It has been an absolute treat here with Magnus Carlsen at the table for day 1B of the main event. This is a freeze-out affair with nearly 1,000 players in the field at this point in time, almost 700 as you can see on day 1B alone. And we're going to hop right into the action here with Barre, who lost some chips, but waking up with a premium hand, raising it up to 3,500 from early position and getting called by Forberg from the cutoff with pocket eights. Spike calling as well from the big blind with sevens. And nobody can be in love with this 5-queen-4 rainbow flop. But I expect Barre to continue quite often. Let's see how he approaches this hand after Spite checks it over to him from the big blind. You could see Forberg just staring him down, maybe trying to get a read. It is a small bet of 3,000. Forberg looks undeterred. He is calling with currently the best hand from the cutoff. And let's see if Spike can get away, being utterly dominated. No, he calls as well. And the King of Diamonds on the turn. Now Barre can be more confident. Obviously, there are some King Queens that players might have. Maybe somebody flopped the set here, but with his stack size, expect to see more chips come in. He is looking down at his chip stack. Thinking things over, he is sitting on about 38,000 with nearly 22,000 in the pot. So close to double the pot in his stack. Whereas some commentators like to say his SPR is near 2. And does bet nearly half the pot with a bet of 10,000. And gets both players to fold after approving to the best hand. And is up to 59,000 in chips. So it was quite fun the last 2 hours with Magnus Carlsen at the table. I did get a chance to speak with my Norwegian colleagues who are doing commentating as well in Norwegian to learn a little bit more about Magnus Carlsen's poker experience. And they shared with me that he has studied quite a bit of poker. He used to belong to the poker trading site that is now defunct Poker X Factor, run by Sheets and Johnny Backs. Two old school members of the poker community, two well-respected and successful members of the poker community as well. So now I'm a little bit less surprised about Carlsen's awareness at the table. But we now, after Barre won the last hand with Big Slick, opening a little bit lighter, or quite a bit lighter actually, because he's under the gun with the King 10 suited. And it's Tom Jacobson thinking about what he wants to do with his King 10 suited, and he calls from middle position. Folds around to Bilstad on the button with 8-6 off, also folding. Spite folds, and let's see if Bold defends with his ace. Currently the best hand, but don't blame him for folding as well, being that there's a lot of better aces in the range of both of these players. And then it could be trouble for him if there's an ace in the flop, not in this particular case. So now I think it's going to be a matter of who wants to steal it away on the 6-5-5 flop. Barre does have a little bit of equity to win the hand with the backdoor flush draw. However, this would end in a split most of the time. And now 100% of the time, after both players improved the two pair and the same two pair with the same kicker on the 10 of club turn. Now it's not going to be of a case of he who bets it gets it, because I expect both players to stick around regardless of the action. And Barre reaching for some chips. It looks like a fairly big bet of 7,000, but once again, I expect Jacobson to stick around. You don't play King 10 suited and then improve to such a strong hand just to fold when the 10 comes. Obviously, he's behind quite a lot of stuff in Barre's range, but do like the call. And then the three of diamonds on the river, completing the e-board. And if there were players in the blind, some of those 4-7s would have completed. You could be concerned about some of those 6-5s. But there should be very little of that in Jacobson's range, and Barre should try to seek some value, being that Jacobson could be calling with a lot of things like pocket 9s, pocket 8s, pocket 7s, but then I would expect a lot of those hands to bet the flop after Barre checked. And all these things might be going through Barre's mind. He is thinking about something, or perhaps trying to have his opponent think that he's thinking about something. And I got to talk to Barre a couple of nights ago, and I have met him before in Estonia, where he has played recently. He's taking his time with this decision with 25,000 in the pot. Bets 20 into 25. It will be 20% of Jacobson's stack to call. I don't foresee him turning his hand into a bluff by raising, and he should be aware that there's not too much worse than him that would call. Obviously, perhaps some weaker 10s, like a 10-queen, 10-jack, but how much of that is in Barre's opening range? Does call, and players will chop things up. Chop, chop. And everybody loves a chop. Haven't got to say that yet today.
Oh, I'm not into blast either.
Carlsen with the easy fold with the 10-4 from under the gun. Jacobson looking ready to play his king-queen offsuit from early position. Raising it up to 2.5x to 4,000. Blinds are now 800, 1600. We'll have one more blind after this on day 1B with blinds at 1,000, 2,000. Players will still be able to enter tomorrow in this freeze-out affair before the start of day two. Once cards on the air, late registration will be closed, but players that do enter before the start of day two will still be getting a healthy 40 big blind stack. While Barre would be peeling off here from the big blind with a min raise, he had a decision to make with the 2.5x, but does opt to call and play this hand out of position. No player getting any love on this 3-5 jack rainbow flop. And Jacobson looking to bet big and continue, and it works with Barre not connecting with any of it. Been having a blast here at Card Casino Bratislava. Haven't had the opportunity to play much poker myself with all the amazing TV table action taking place both in tournaments and in high stakes cash games, including the other night a 50-50 100 PLO affair. with tons of massive pots in that one. But Card Casino have been the gracious hosts of the Norwegian Championship this year. After spending many years in Dublin, many of the best dealers and floor have come out for the Norwegian Championship. So Fold raising it up, but this may be a mistimed raise from the button. You can't blame him from opening the button here. But Bari waking up with the pocket rockets from the small blind. Bari thinking perhaps about how much he wishes to raise. I do not think he's going to smooth call these rockets. While it would be sneaky, you really don't want to be doing this out of position. In fact, you shouldn't really be slow playing your aces in any spot. Because if he just calls, the player in the big blind will be priced in with most of his holdings as well. It does look like a 3-bet. We will get the sizing soon enough. And it is a large 3-bet, the 13,500. Magnus Carlsen folds his rags and Volt folds the button. I think that's the second time that Barre was unable to see a flop with his rockets, but that's how poker works sometimes. I do like the fact that he 3-bet there for the reasons Barre gave. Of early position and mid position folds before Spite opts to bet and open with his ace 5 offsuit to 3,500. Barre on the button after just taking down the blinds and a little bit more with his aces the previous hand. It's looking to get back into action with his king 10 from the button. And it does indeed cold call. And we'll be playing this hand in position, depending on whether Jacobson decides to 3-bet and change things up. But it looks like he will just be defending his big blind. Bring three players to the flop. And Jacobson popping the open-ender, Barre with a gut shot, and Spite. Although he's ahead percentage-wise, this isn't the kind of flop he wanted to see with his ace 5. Does bet less than one-third of the pot with the 4,000 chip bet. Barre also has back doors to the flush with his king of hearts and does call in position. And I expect to see Jacobson call as well. Double checking his cards once again and does indeed make the call. The Jack of Hearts on the turn is a very interesting card indeed, especially for Barre, who now has a flush draw. He also has an open-ended straight draw to any queen, any seven. The two cards that Jacobson actually has in his hand. And both Jacobson and Spite check it over to Barre. He may be looking for a free river or may be looking to try to take it down now, understanding that he isn't in the worst shape if a river card does need to come. Let's see what his style of play dictates. Does indeed check to see a free river card, hoping to complete something here. And it's the ace of diamonds on the river. Spite now with the check mark, but it is a scary board for him. And if he does try to get some more value, don't expect it to happen with the bet. He does bet, and I expect to see both players fold. can't blame him for trying to squeak out that value, although Bari from the button could have been floating with a better ace set already paired with the board. That isn't the case here. Bari may be thinking about bluffing a raise here, but I think he will fold. He's counting out some chips, though. The one thing I don't think he can do here is just call. Especially with the player behind. While it looks like he has some showdown value, it isn't much. Especially against a hijack open. And even with the big blind calling, very often those 6, 8, 9, etc. connect fairly well with the big blind's calling range. As well as the jack, and even some weak aces. And is indeed making a move, Barre. Showing something that we haven't seen yet. Let's see if this works. Spite does have top pair, but once again, he has that kicker issue. And there's a lot going on this board. A flush would have completed, a queen 10 would have completed a straight, even a 7-10, a 5-7. But there's those ace nines, ace eights, ace, and more importantly, the ace jack. That could be ahead, but we see that Barre is just making a move based on the situation, based on the pot. Spite is shaking a little bit. It would be a significant portion. It would be for basically his entire stack if he's able to find the correct call. However, he may wind up folding the best hand here. Love this by Barre. Putting the pressure. And it works! Barre stealing one away from Spite. Amazing play here by Barre. And Barre, who is below 40,000 at one point, is getting closer and closer to that starting stack. Players can still enter now for a starting stack and even up until the start of tomorrow. Barre would like to end today with a bit more than that and is on his way to do so. Amazing play there. Getting Spite to fold that top pair. Olsen, who was quite active very early at the feature table before, did slow down on his aggression during the latter half of the last blind level. But he's back in action now, this time with a semi-loose open with ace-8 offsuit from under the gun. If you're in a later position, this wouldn't be considered a loose open, but from under the gun, one can consider it. But so far, everybody's respecting it. Nobody's showing up with anything. And does pick up the blinds in the ante. But will be in the big blind himself. So that money that he just earned, most of it's going back in now, and the rest would go back in the small blind. It costs 3,200 every time you're in the blind, because you have to put in the big blind ante on top of the big blind itself. The innovative big blind ante has sped up poker quite a bit. It's hard to picture the days where everybody is still individually putting their antes. I can't think of a place that has not adopted the big blind ante. In the beginning, a few places adopted a button ante instead of a big blind ante, but now everybody is using a big blind. Some are playing around with the sizing. I did see one event recently that had a big blind ante, but it was 100% of the 150% of the big blind. And I've been to other events over the years where the big blind ante has been the size of the small blind, but 99% of the time the big blind ante is as it sounds. It's a big blind putting it in for the size of a big blind. But back to the action. Barre back in motion with the ace-7 offsuit from the hijack, raising to 3,500. So far, so good.
Me too.
And gets a walk.
Because they kill so much.
So Bari up to 90,000.
Sitting duck.
And this time it's fight under the gun. Gets rid of his king 8. Fold, also folding his 6-3. And Bari folding as well. Magnus Carlsen, the chess grandmaster, folding his queen 9. Perhaps Jacobson will do something with his king 3 suited, but not this time. And it's Forsberg on the button with 10-6, also getting under his hand. Does not seem happy about it either. Onsen completing with this pretty 10-7 suited. Well, Bilstad check his option from the big blind. We're trying to rep a much stronger hand than his 10-4 off. It does look like he's going to try to rep something stronger. And this may work, a raise to 5,600. So for 3.5 big blinds. And does get the table chip leader Hans Christian to fold a dominating 10-7, although it's not really that dominating because the 7 kicker really comes into play. Fold opening for 2.5x to 4,000 from under the gun with King Jack suited. Maybe doing something was it? Nope. The sides against it was reaching for chips for a moment with this Trey Deuce suited. But that's a bit too weak to be playing. It's still 3 high. Onsen folding the button with this King Deuce. Bilstad following suit, but expects fight to call, and indeed he does. So 10,400 euro, not euro, but 10,400 chips in the pot, with both players witnessing the deuce, four, queen, rainbow flop. Does not connect with either player, but if both continues, it may get the job done. Both players having backdoors, both having a few more, and is technically ahead with this jack kicker, but the hand is already over with the bold betting. Just 3,000, but that was enough to get the job done, with Spike not wanting to put any more chips into the pot with such a speculative holding. Looks like we'll have all the early position players folding, but Forsberg from the hijack with the sixes is likely to do something here, likely a raise. And it is a min raise to 3,200. We haven't seen a min raise in a very long time at this feature table. Mm-hmm. focusing your 3-bet here. So Onsen, who was being very aggressive early at the feature table, quieted down for quite some time, is now back up to putting pressure on players. And so far, nobody having enough to play back at him. Let's see what Forberg decides to do with the sixes, if he feels he's getting the right price. Perhaps he gets a read on his opponent and even 4-bets, but I think the likely scenario is that we see him call. Forberg does make the call to bring the pot up to $18,800 already. And the sixes don't look that bad now on a 5-5-4 flop. There are two spades there, neither player having the spades. Forberg does check though, after Onsen did begin things off at the 3-bet. Onsen showing no fear, bets out $6,500, about 1/3 of the pot. Forberg not going anywhere, at least from now. He's at least either going to call or perhaps even a raise, but it looks like a call coming. Does indeed call. The nine of spades on the turn keeps Forberg ahead. He may not realize that he's ahead. Let's see if Onsen can keep his foot on the gas. Five more pressure.
Well, never not, never team is a spade or like that.
It is a third spade on the board as well, with Onsen having no spades in his hand, but that's not stopping him at all. And he's making it big. It may not be as big as I thought, but it was a half the pot. Gets Forberg to fold the better hand. And it's up to nearly 300,000 in chips from his opening start of the day stack of 100,000. Here's a quick look at all the chip counts. We mentioned that Hans Christian Olsen was near 300,000. There's several other players though with more than a starting stack, including the legendary Magnus Carlsen with 155,100 in chips. Meanwhile, there's three players with less than 2/3 of their starting stack as well. Carlsen has not been getting too much that he can play with as of yet, since at least the break. And Onsen, once again, back to his aggressive ways, opening to 4,500, so a rather large opening from him this time around from the hijack. He has been switching it up. Bilstead has the dominating queen jack, but there's still more players to come. And Spite also has a dominating king queen and is just calling from the button for more than 10% of his stack.
45?
Already confirming the larger sizing. Probably would have liked to have defended to a smaller bet. Let's see what he does to a bigger bet. It's nearly a 3x raise. Does indeed still call, and there's already 13,000 in the pot. Nobody getting any love on this 10-10 deuce spot.
I'll check.
This fight.
Always check at this table.
Boris says he always checks on this table. And Nate changes at this board, I will check. Onsen checks as well on Svite. Also checks now. Barre improves to the best hand with two pair on the eight of diamonds turn. And with it checking all the way through, perhaps he understands he's ahead. And is reaching for chips. bet of 6,000. At least gets one of them to fold, who seems very table aware and spite folding as well. And Barre back to a starting stack. I mean, he was below 40,000 and now near a starting, back at a starting stack once again.
This guy had some phenomenal
Magnus Carlsen having some fun with his fellow Norwegian table mates. Reminds me of when we watched Espen Ulenjørstad play the 2022 WSOP main event champ. He's also in the house, as humble as ever. These are two legends in their field. Magnus, obviously, in chess. Espen, obviously, in poker. But I have a feeling Magnus can play better poker than Espen can chess. But I would have to ask Espen himself whether he has played chess before. I wouldn't be too shocked that the answer was that he's also a good chess player.
So heads up, Vesu.
So it's Oscar Bilstedt opening up the action from the hijack with a pretty king-jack suited. And so far, so good. Let's see what Magnus Carlsen turns up with. An ace-5, this is certainly defendable if Carlsen chooses to do so. Carlsen has been rather tight lately, but I am not surprised to see a call here. A decent flop for the opener, Bilstedt does flop a flush draw with his two overcards, and Carlsen does check. Let's see if Bilstedt continues. The c-bet rate of players has been pretty high on day 1B in the main event, whether they've made it or not.
4.5.
I'm also pretty sure that if Bilstedt is played back with, he's not going anywhere, being that he has half a starting stack with tons of hope on the turn and river. But right now, Carlsen, if the hand ended here, would have the best hand with ace-5. But does indeed fold, and Bilstedt takes one off the chess grandmaster.
Og kanskje mange har fått med seg her, det varte ikke så veldig lenge for min main event I år. Det noen som må rykke tidlig, men det også noen som da følgelig må doble tidlig, kanskje til og med triple tidlig. Kajan Mokkeri, her ser det ut som det går veldig bra innledningsvis.
Det går veldig bra nå, veldig bra.
Hva har skjedd?
Nei, jeg har vunnet veldig mange potter da. Veldig mange potter og mange gode hender.
Betyr det at det har vært showdown, eller at du bare har spilt vanlig Mokkeri-stil, hvor du egentlig aldri har fått sett et eneste kort du har?
Vanlig Mokkeri-stil.
Det I hvert fall et bord som nødt til å unngjelde her fra en dessverre alt for velspillende Mokkeri. En av dem ser jeg kanskje Tore Pedersen som sitter på motsatt side her. Det vanskelig å forholde seg til akkurat nå?
Ja, han ikke lett å spille mot, nei. Han vet hva han gjør. Det jeg ikke tvil om.
Skal la deg få lov å ta en avgjørelse I forkant her I hvert fall, uten at man blander seg inn. Men det som helt sikkert at det meget god stemning på bordet, og så kan vi kanskje følge denne potten her, se hvordan det blir spilt, for det litt et oppspill fra Mokkeri før vi da får et syn fra Smallblind, fra Tore Pedersen. Og det nettopp de to gutta som skal inn I en pott her. Vi fortsetter på, se hvordan dette går.
Det kommer til showdown.
Check på bordet 8S10, to hjerter. Det en Mokkeri som går ut og byr 2800 inn I den potten, og det kommer et syn fra Tore Pedersen. Det betyr at vi da etter hvert får et turn-kort. Og turn, den blar opp en hjerter 6. Bordet ligger altså da tre hjerter I bordet, 8 S10-6, og på river så får vi til slutt den fjerde hjerteren. Det hjerte 3, og det Tore Pedersen som tjekker. Det Mokri som sitter bak og går inn i boksen, velger å by 15.000. 15.000, det tungt å syne det for Tore Pedersen. Og føler du at det hjalp at det var TV-kameraer og live-kommentering her, Tore?
Jeg hadde ingenting å si. Jeg hadde kastet uansett. Men kunne vært det bedre enn alt det kunne vært.
Som dere ser, vi hygger oss her nede, og det veldig bra stemning rundt pokerbordene.
Well, thank you, Spede, for bringing us some of the action at the side tables that was down on the ground floor. There's tons of action going on down there. Nearby the feature table, there's also 20 to 30 tables of action going on. And it doesn't look like we missed much with Spite picking up 4,000 chips with the ace nine. Perhaps we missed another hand as well. But I love the fact that we can get some coverage from the side tables. It worked out so nicely last night during the semifinals of the Heads Up Affair, as we were able to get all the big hands from that side table while watching Simon Gunbrandsen defeat the one and only 2022 WSOP main event, Espen Ulen Jorstad. But back to the action. Bold looks ready to open up, and indeed he does with his king queen offsuit from early slash middle position to 3,500. Barry folds, I think Carlsen will fold his king four, and indeed he does. Jacobson cannot play the 7-4 off on the button, but Forberg could do something with his deuces. He could call, he could raise, he could also fold. And perhaps it's good that he did, considering Onsen waking up at the sevens. And he is quite aggressive.
We take it in English.
So that no fans can
While many players would call here, I wouldn't have been surprised if Onsen 3-bet. But he did indeed call. And that ace high flop hits more of the opener's range, but it does check all the way through, and Onsen still ahead with the sevens reaching for chips.
So
and Onsen with a, sort of like a probing bet here, but is ahead, betting for 3,500. Fold, even though the price is right and his king and queen are alive, he could be drawing dead. He wouldn't necessarily always be drawing dead there, obviously, even if the ace was paired up, as a 10 would have given him Broadway, but then he'd be drawing very thin. But Onsen, once again, picking up a pot. He's never afraid to put chips in the pot, and it's paid off nicely for him today on day 1B of the main event. Not immediately folding, but he does eventually fold his king seven suited. Fold would be playing this in late position, but let's see what he does in early position. It looks like he'll play it in early position and on open pot as well, opening to 3,500. This Bari's decision is easy, but Carlsen's decision may be less so. He could either call or raise. I'd be surprised to see a fold, and he takes the safer option with just a call. Expect a 3-bet here by Forberg. He might also flap considering he's on the button, but ace-queen is a very strong hand, and we see that it is dominating Bold's open. The issue with 3-betting here is that Bold did open from very early position, hasn't been super active. So once again, a call is a safer option, but I would like to see a 3-bet. Does raise it to 10,500. about to six big blinds, give or take. Watson not immediately folding his 5-4, but does fold now. This 3-bet will likely get Bilstad to quickly fold. Otherwise, he may have peeled if Forberg just called from the button with his ace-queen. And after Volt folds, it's up to Carlsen, and Carlsen folds as well. And Forberg picking up 11,000 chips without seeing a flop. Barre, who is over an opening stack after being super low earlier, opens at 3,500 from early position with King 10 offsuit. The action's pause on Jacobson with ducks. He calls from the hijack. Folds around despite in the big blind with the jack 8 suited, who is likely to at least complete, and indeed he does. And not the worst spot for two of the players here, despite with a flush draw, and also the 9 would give him a straight barre with middle pair and a backdoor flush draw. Jacobson with not much of anything. But it does check around to the 7 diamond turn. Despite checking for a second time, let's see if Barre now wants to bet his pair. Is reaching for chips. It looks like for more than half the pot he will be betting. For 8,000, that gets Jacobson to snap fold now. Is Spike going to call? It looks like he will. And the 9 of clubs on the river. While it wasn't a heart, Spike was able to complete his straight. He does have less than a pot size bet in his stack. Decides not to bet at all and just bet a small portion of it. That's a quarter of the pot. So even though Barre's behind, he does have very good odds to call. But there are a lot of hands bluffing on this sizing. Barre can also opt to turn his hand into a bluff, but there's very little point in doing that on this board and what he holds. So it'll likely either be a call or a fold. However, it is getting later on day 1B. Players can be getting tired, and it could be a little bit exhausting for some players on the TV table, but is able to lay down his hand, and correctly so. Very nice read there by Barre. Who now has so many chips, he's able to make some change. How the tides have turned for Barre. All the way around to Onsen and the cutoff. He likes playing unopened pots, but maybe not with Jack 7 off. And not this time, but Bill said with the ace 10 from the button, expect to see him do something. Let's see what his sizing will be. It looks like the 3,500, a little more than a min raise fight. Looks ready to fold the 7-5 suited, indeed he does. And bold though, waking up with the ace queen. This could be trouble for Bill Stad. Let's see what bold opts to do. Very often players will be three betting their ace queen to a button open from the big blind. I would expect to see that actually from bold. And does three bet to 11,000. That's on the large side, but not necessarily from out of position. Let's see if Bill Stad can get away from this. We could see that it's ace 10 is dominated by bold's ace queen. It looks like he will be calling out of position, and if an ace comes on this flop, it could be showers for Bill Stad, assuming it's not an ace 10. But instead, it's bold improving to top pair on the queen 6-5 rainbow flop. Let's see if he just tries to disguise the strength of his hand. He was the last aggressor with the three bet, so one would expect him to bet very often, regardless of the fact that he flopped top pair or not, and bet 7,000 into a pot of 24 and change. And Bill Stad making the call. Basically, just footing bold there. And Bill Stad's now drawing dead. And I don't expect bold to be that scared of that eight of hearts. Let's see if a second bullet comes out of bold stack. Bill Stad just has one SPR in his stack. Stack to pot ratio. It's a bet for 11,000. Let's see if Bill Stad gets the message here that his ace high is not good. He's not immediately folding though, and looks like he will be making the call. And the four of clubs on the river, Bill Stad not connecting with any bit of it. Bolt was betting out the whole way after three betting preflop with his ace queen from the big blind. And Bolt bets he should be jamming, and indeed he does. And now Bill Stad being put to the test. Can he make a hero call with ace high? We know he shouldn't. But he did call that flop in turn. Is reaching for some chips, maybe looking to make a hero call on the TV table, not this time. And if he looks back at this hand, he will see that he saved his chips. Maybe should have folded at some earlier point, but at least saved them at the end. And now Vold is double a starting stack for the first time at the feature table. And another familiar TV table dealer, one of the friendly dealers that goes around on the circuit, Charlie. I've seen him a few times this year at other stops. I think it's the first time I've seen him at the TV table this year, but that doesn't mean that he hasn't been, because I am reporting even more than I do commentating. And then I might not notice who is dealing at the TV table. But meanwhile, Onsen opens the hijack with Jack 9, and Spite, once again, not being tight, flatting from the button with Ace 7 offsuit, is actually ahead, but not necessarily ahead of the range of Onsen. But then again, Onsen's VPIP is rather high, especially during this blind level. But Onsen flopping top pair, getting there with this Jack 9, at least thus far. and he's not afraid to continue at times when he doesn't hit it. This time he does have the top pair. It is a scary board. There's open-ended straight possibilities, flush possibilities, but Spite has none of that. Onsen able to take it down with a single bet. It is up to 306,000.
Altså man beveger seg ned I det som bondetasjen, nullte etasje her I Card Casino, så finner man ordentlig perler av et bord. Det allerede ymtet frem på at hvis dette her hadde vært TV-bordet, så hadde poker blitt forbudt I Norge. Jeg vet ikke helt hvor dette stemmer, men jeg tar på meg table-kapteinen umiddelbart. Petter, katastrofe, Bjørkel Kristiansen, god dag.
Helle.
Hvordan går det?
Pokeren går også veldig bra, men her det helt fantastisk. Og det burde vært TV-bord. For her det ekstremt hyggelig.
Men jeg sitter og ser på stacken din, du har jo nesten startstack.
Ja da, så det ikke krise I det hele tatt. Men det hyggeligere på bordet enn hvordan det har gått med pokeren. Det det. Men det veldig hyggelig, nå har jeg fått påspannert massasje her også. Det var veldig hyggelig.
Men du føler at livet vondt når du på tur, du spiller poker, du koser deg, du har massasje ved siden av, du har sannsynligvis det morsomste bordet som mulig å oppdrive I hele lokalet?
Det helt korrekt. Ting veldig fint nå, altså. Det det.
Da gleder jeg meg til å få deg på TV-bordet etter hvert.
Helt konge.
Vi kan jo ta en tur litt videre her også, bare ta en titt på bordet, og jeg må bare spørre kanskje en annen person her. Det lett å fokusere når det såpass god stemning her?
Ja, det går helt fint. Jeg ikke noe god, så det går helt fint.
Det ymtes frem på at mannen må få en øl, men jeg kan si såpass at de gutta som her, det mulig at de fremstår useriøse. Jeg har spilt mot flere av dem før, jeg vet at det her langt tøffere motstand enn kanskje ser ut som.
So thank you once again, Spade, for showing us what's going on downstairs. We just did only miss Spite win a hand with Big Slick to gain some much needed chips.
Perfect. Okay. Yep.
However, it does look like Spite does have a bit of chips in his stack there. I'm gonna get an update on his chip count where possible. But we will see. But he should be approaching a starting stack now. Meanwhile, Billstad must have lost another pot. I mean, we did see him with that ace 10 against ace queen before Svede took over for a little while to show us the downstairs tables. It is an early position with the ace 5 suited, down to just 15 big blinds. More than two of them are going in with this ace 5 suited. And Spite, we guessed around 60, that's what he has. Does like to see a lot of flops and calls here with this king jack offsuit. And let's see what Barre does with his ace 10 on the button. He would be in position. I won't be surprised by any of the three possible actions in call, fold, or three bet. Plays it the safest way with a fold. Magnus Carlsen will be folding in the small blind and expect Jacobson not to defend with the six deuce. One of the worst hands in poker, and he agrees with that. Some players will be defending with that though. And Spite improving to top two pair on the Jack 8 King Rainbow Flop. Billstad doesn't have much hope at all, would need a pair of runners, and is super short on chips. Does indeed check. Let's see if Spite is going to trap or try to get Billstad to do something with this. It is a bet of a little less than half the pot. Billstad snap folds. And it's even now shorter on chips, but because he didn't continue bet on that flop, did save himself some chips. A bunch of rags so far. But Bold likely to do something with his pocket pair, even though it's a baby pair with the fours. And an unopened pot, expect him to be the one to open in the hijack. And does open for 3,500. Barre, who after being under 40,000 did peak a little bit above his starting stack, is now slightly below, deciding what to do with his ace-7 off. Does fold it. Magnus Carlsen quickly folding his 10-5 suited, as does Jacobson with his 10-3 off, but Forberg should be defending the big blind with his pretty suited connectors. He's actually technically ahead equity-wise against fours, but Bold's range is much wider than fours, and that's near the bottom of his range, in fact. Does just call, and then flops top pair on the 8-2-6 flop with two hearts. Checks it over to Bold, who is going to continue with this four for 4,500. I don't expect Forberg to go anywhere with the top pair, at least at the moment. Does not have any flush draw, but he does have some backdoor redraws to the straight. Does check call. A queen of diamonds on the turn may slow down Bold, or maybe he will rep that that queen also helped him. Forberg checking once again. Bold checking back. And the queen of spades on the river pairing the board. So now, if Forberg was thinking of folding earlier, now it's less likely that Bold has a queen. On Bold, on the other hand, may be more confident in his fours as well. Certainly if he had a hand like nines, tens, or jacks, he would feel more comfortable betting here. But it may be Forberg trying to set the price. Let's see. Indeed, he does. Forberg firing out for 5,200. Bold probably thinking about how many bluffs his opponent has in his range. Now, some of them could be the 7-9, 5-7 that could be bluffing here, any two hearts. And Bold hoping to catch a bluff, but not this time. Forberg was betting for value and gets the job done. Great job there by Charlie, our TV table dealer. And we can take a look at the chip counts while the dealer change is being made. I got to chat with Doris for a little while during the last break. She was one of our TV table dealers, an old friend of mine. And she mentioned that she will be dealing on the outer of the tables the rest of the way, at least today. It was nice to see her first on the stream and then later on in person. But let's see if we can recognize the next TV table dealer. They all do a fantastic job. There's a lot of pressure not only on the players, but for the dealers to try to not make any mistakes. And we're all human, we all can make mistakes. But this is not one of the TV table dealers that I would know his name off the top of my head. But shout out to you, whoever you might be, and maybe I will meet you later in the week. You can see the field has grown to 677 entries here on day 1B. Close to 200 players have hit the rail with no chance to re-enter, as this is a pure freeze-out affair. Even if you bust it out on day 1A, you can't get back in on day 1B. Or can you get in before the start of day 2, like fresh players can? There are a handful of players still arriving today that will likely late enter before the start of tomorrow at 12 o'clock. We will be live with you 30 minutes later at 12:30. As we are broadcasting on a 30-minute delay. But Barre opens up to 3,500 and a bold move here by Johansson with the ace deuce. From the big blind 3-betting to 10,500. Barre has that dominating ace. You can see it would be a split pot nearly 30% of the time. Would be playing this hand position Munson has been quite active. Bari, being an intelligent player himself, has likely recognized that. But on the other hand, he does have just A7. He'd be much happier with a hand like Ace-Queen or an Ace-Jack suited. So I wouldn't be surprised if Munson gets away with yet another one. Bari may want to reevaluate call on the flop. I do not see him for betting. Is thinking things over. And he did the one thing I didn't think he would do. He four bet to 26,000, and this should get the job done. And as I say that, I see Onsen, this could be a leveling war, reaching for some chips. Maybe this is for posture stake. It'd be absolutely unbelievable, though, if he five bets here. I mean, both players have an ace, but that second card for both players is crap, especially ace deuce. A7 is a little bit better. Onsen perhaps trying to get a read from his opponent. And shows the ace. Now Bari's not going to know, and Bari shows his ace too, so neither player is going to know. Obviously Onsen knows that now it was a good fold, because any card's higher than a 2, but Bari may think he made a move with the worst hand. He had the better hand, but it was still quite nice table awareness that he can get away with that. And blinds have gone up. This is the final blind level of the day, with a small blind of 1,000, a big blind of 2,000, along with a 2,000 big blind ante. So it's going to cost 5,000 chips every orbit for every player. If we're going to use Harrington's M, anybody entering now with the starting stack does have 20M, but also has 50 big blinds. It really depends on which way you're thinking about your stack size. Both are valid ways to evaluate your stack. Fold appears ready to open his sixes, with nearly double a starting stack. It does open for 4,500. Can't open for 3,500 blinds, they'd go up, so it's 4,500. Carlsen folds his weak ace. Playing fairly tight, Carlsen, at the TV table. Not that he should be playing looser than he is. I mean, he's playing very well. Just not really getting cards to play, but looks like he's having fun in the meantime. Instead, thinking what to do. He only has 16,000 left. It's really 18,000 because it doesn't include the 2,000 he has in front of him. Began the hand with 20. 2,000 went into the big blind ante. Let's see if this is the spot, hoping to double. Does just peel with the short stack though. He has 14,000 in his stack with 12,000 in the middle. And if he tries to take it away here, this is typically the kind of flop that would favor a big blind, but Volt flops bottom set would be going nowhere if Bilstad jammed. Let's see if Volt will bet. He should be betting because it is a scary flop. Bets 5,000. That's 2,500 actually, so perhaps trying to induce Bilstad to come in over the top, but not this time. Bilstad will save his 7 remaining big blinds for a better opportunity.
Jeg sliter med å komme opp fra 1300 ranking. Jeg tror hvis jeg skal komme over der, kommer jeg starte å studere spillet. Jeg bare bruker kun konklusjoner.
Ja, det liksom, hvis du på en måte ikke får tilbake.
Ja, da kan jeg vet ikke hva som jeg tror ikke det har tatt så
lang tid. For det som hvis du begynner veldig mye, så det.
Ja, da det.
Da lærer du jo
gjerne.
Jo, men også lærer du liksom det.
Ja, jeg spilte aldri da jeg var liten, men på en måte nå i de siste her, så det nå synes jeg det et bort.
Full folks, but Bari is already reaching for chips.
With
his queen jack from early position, a raise to 4,500 appears. Indeed it is. Carlsen once again with no cards.
Hva spiller du dine?
Carlsen though, who showed he can 3-bet with many different variety of cards, opts not to do so here and just calls the button and will want to play this hand in position with ace 10. And it will be heads up going into the flop.
Håper ikke det langt siden. Du skylder meg fortsatt sett på noe, det det vi gjør. Ja,
Either player connecting with the 2-6-5 flop. Onsen still ahead with his ace 10. And it looks like, as usual, we'll be firing out a continuation bet. Looks like 6,000 and 14,000. Bari quickly folds. Easy game for Onsen.
Han sterkere enn Big Bang på det bordet.
Det race med 60 da.
Ja,
det syv for ikke. Jeg kanskje ikke etter det forrige. Ikke etter det. Det heller ikke. Nå får vi ned.
Folds around to Onsen in the cutoff, probably fold to the button. Although Onsen does like to play pots, and especially in open ones, not with 9 deuce. We can only see one of Bilstad's cards, but the one we saw is not pretty. And Spight will be doing something with his ace jack from the small blind. Raising to 4,500. I don't think Fold will be defending. And a quick hand and a quick pot for Spite. Well played there. Should be raising against a more aggressive opponent. You can think about just completing there, knowing that the opponent is raising most big blinds and come in with the 3-bet. But I do prefer the raise based on the table dynamics. We of course see more information than the players, as we see everybody's whole card, so perhaps it's easier for me to say than some of the players at the table.
Fight.
Jacobson raising to 5,000. King 10 offsuit, and Forberg deciding what to do with his queen jack suited. This is a pretty hand. It's much prettier in a deep stacked cash game. Forberg decides that it's not pretty enough for him to play. Onsen, on the other hand, who can afford some chips, I don't expect him to be folding his sixes. I'm just not sure if he's calling or 3-betting. Does look like a call. Perhaps pricing in later players depending on what they have. So far, nobody really having much, including Bari in the big blind with Jack 3 offsuit. He does get rid of it. Sixes remain ahead on the 8-7-7 flop. Let's see if Jacobson now is repping more than the King 10. He was the early position opener and does bet 10,000 into 15,000, putting Onsen in a strange spot. Because even if he feels he's right here, there are still two more cards to come. But we'll wait to see what happens, at least on the turn, because he does call. The pot's already at 35,000. If Onsen felt that his sixes were good on that flop, he should feel that the three of diamonds doesn't really change that. But Jacobson, continuing his story and betting 16,000, can he get the table chip leader to fold the better hand? Jacobson drawing to any 8, king, or 10, but he may not realize that 8 is even good for him.
Six, deep up.
And Onsen doesn't appear to be going anywhere.
Har du sex syv, så får du alle pengene. Har du sex syv, så får du alle pengene.
Onsen taking his time this time. Might be the longest we've seen him make a decision in the 3+ hours that he's been at the feature table. Is trying to chat a little bit with Jacobson, perhaps trying to get a little bit of information of where he stands. I'd be curious if he would do this with a made hand as well to try to disguise how strong he is. If not, this would be a tell that he has a medium strength hand. It is something you could do when you're last to act on the river. But when you do it on the turn, you could be giving away some information. But does fold the better hand. Well played by Jacobson. Aggression did pay off and is showing the King 10.
You elsker kongetid.
And Onsen getting a nice laugh about that. Should appreciate that move as he's done several similar ones himself.
Ja, det det bästa hänger jag fått idag.
Du lite med 60 år där.
Han är aldrig med där.
Jag har fick med på kast. Det var ju inte hur han. Det skulle gå på för så pass bra stack.
Hä?
Det kan fast inte på där.
Du gör det ja. Ja.
För det är det så tidigt att det kommer ett slag till.
Ja.
Så du ser fast att det måste ha syns så tydligt. Ja. På flopp också, då har det kostat 10,000 i stack.
Ja.
We haven't seen Magnus Carlsen, who's in the picture right there, play a hand in quite some time. It's not exactly his fault either. He hasn't been getting the cards on a fairly active table. But we do expect Werberg to open up his ace jack from any position. He is in early position. Opens for 4,500. Onsen folding. Bilstad down to 6.5 bigs now, with the big blind creeping up on him. Doesn't have anything to play back with though, with the 8-7. Holds around to Carlsen. We were just saying how Carlsen hasn't played a hand in a while, but this is going to be one that he should be playing in his pocket queens in the big blind. We should be seeing a three bet here a lot of the time. Let's see what the chess grandmaster decides to do. Does just call, disguising the strength of his hand. Looks like a random defend. Meanwhile, he has the queens. However, the problem of doing what he just did is you're playing this hand now out of position with an overcard to your queens. Can Forberg steal this one away? I don't think that Carlsen's going anywhere on a single bet. So it would have to be on later streets. Forberg would have to continue the aggression. But he's shown before that he's capable of doing so. Warburg. Didn't hit the flop exactly, but his ace is live. He may feel his jack could be live, and a queen would give him Broadway. Of course, Carlsen has that block. Carlsen did call that bet to see the nine of diamond turn. And now this board does kind of hit a big blind's range to some degree, other than that king. But Carlsen doesn't have a weak holding, despite not three betting from the big blind, is ahead with his queen still, but is facing an early position opener who has a lot of kings in his range. Should feel more comfortable now that it checked back, but an ace on the river. Forbert gets there. Carlsen can't be too pleased with both a king and an ace on the board when he's holding those queens. But we'll be betting anyway. And I don't expect to see a raise, but Forbrick should be calling here. Obviously, he has a blocker for that Broadway. If he had Queen Jack, he would have the nuts on the board, but he has blockers for that. But Forbrick did river top pair. Let's see if Carlsen could steal this away. I'd be shocked, though, if Forbrick folded the top pair, despite how wet this board is. Forbrick not immediately doing anything. He is counting out the chips for the call, and he makes a call to pick off Carlsen's bluff with the queens. On that kind of board, it is a bluff. Was not for value. Hoping maybe to get some kings to fold. I don't think he was trying to get 10 to call, but perhaps that was his strategy. It's hard to get into a head as somebody as intelligent as Carlsen. But Forbert picks up the pot and seems very pleased about it as well. We are approaching the end of the day. There should be about 40 minutes left to play today. Give or take, they'll probably announce final X number of hands in about 30 minutes. So we still have some play left, but not as much as we had before. But there's still tons of action left in this tournament. It is a 5-day event. We're only on day 1B. Tomorrow at noon will be the start of day 2. Players can still enter and late register before the start of day 2. The only thing they can't do is if they bust it out on day 1A or day 1B is re-enter, as this is a freeze out in the main event. But we're in a limp pot between Magnus Carlsen and Jacobsen. Nothing happening on the pot, but Jacobsen improving on the turn. So Carlsen, who's been rather quiet earlier on, is involved in two pots, but this one is not that big and gives up on it fairly easily in a blind versus blind spot in a limp pot, while Jacobsen adds 2,000 to his stack instead of giving away a four. Hansen, who was quite active earlier on, has slowed down a little bit, but who can blame him on this particular hand? But expect Bilstad to jam in his 17. Only has 6.5 big blinds. Indeed, he does from early position. Spite maybe would have liked to have played this 10-9 suited, but not to a shove. And oh my God, Volk waking up with the pocket rockets. Let's see if he isolates or just calls. Unfortunate for Bilstad, who has been patient with the short stack. Found a good spot to get it in, only to run into Volt's aces, but he is not out yet because we still have a board to run out. We have seen stranger things in sevens and aces, but perhaps Volt's just call will get Carlsen to try to isolate with the ace queen, or at least get him involved with the call. It is a super strong hand, but it isn't nearly as strong as pocket aces, of course, and in fact does not play well at all against pocket aces. You'd want to have one of those 10-9 suited hands instead of a ace-queen. But it doesn't look like Carlsen is ready to give up on it. He hasn't sniffed out that Fold was being a little bit sneaky with his aces by just calling from the hijack. Let's see if he induces anything out of Carlsen, because if Fold raises, Carlsen can easily fold. But Carlsen is the one to isolate, raising it up to 50,000. We could be losing Carlsen as well. Now I don't expect Volt to just call. I expect Volt to get it in, but maybe that'll signal to Carlsen, even though he put in nearly half his stack, to get out of the way. Let's see how this plays out. Very exciting hand, and Volt jamming for nearly 200,000. Carlsen immediately folding, aware of how behind he is, and will be pleased to see, despite getting trapped a little bit by putting that 50,000 in, that he probably would have lost the rest. And now it's Bilstad at risk with sevens versus aces. And oh my God, Bilstad staying alive as of so far, flopping a set and doubling up, actually tripling up, thanks to Carlsen with a full house, cracking Bold's aces. But Bold still picked up some chips, compliments of Magnus Carlsen, thanks to his big three bet to 50,000. So although Vold could have won more than 50,000 that pot and sent Bilstad to the rail, the bad beat actually didn't hurt him too bad. Thanks to him flatting, I'm pretty sure that if it was a three bet there, that we would have seen right away Carlsen getting out of the way. And then it would have cost him some chips, Volt, instead of gaining some chips. Meanwhile, Bilstad should be happy, considering that players aren't allowed to re-enter, that he is beyond the 20 big blind mark and not out of the tournament. A little luck never hurts in poker, especially tournament poker. To win a big field event, very often you have to get lucky at some point. If Bilstad goes on to run deep or win this event, we will remember that hand where he cracked Bold's aces with his pocket sevens. Meanwhile, chess grandmaster Magnus Carlsen, who is in decent shape, sitting on more than 150 before, is now down to something between 65 and 70,000 in chips. Still will have more than 30 big blinds, but the stack is not as healthy as before. But meanwhile, over to this hand, we had Jacobson open with the ace 10, Onsen defending his big blind with a suited ace 7. No love for either player, the 9-6-4 flop. The two of spades turn would bring some flush draws to completion, but neither player has a spade for even a draw. And Onsen, after going check-check on the flop, is making a stab at it on the turn. And might get the better hand, the ace 10 to fold. Indeed he does. Once again, Onsen just getting away with murder.
Nå har du fått for mye tips fra alle som sitter og ser på TV.
tips?
Nei, nei, jeg har ikke snakket om det.
Quite involved holding their weak holdings from early position. Looks like Barry has something to think about. We haven't seen his cards yet. Medium strength hands here with the ace 8 offsuit. Those decide to play it with the raise to 4,500. That will get Magnus Carlsen to fold. Fold around to Forberg, who should be folding the button here with only 9-3 offsuit. Also folding in the small blind with queen 9. And despite getting some chips, trade deuce is not defendable. And Barre with the ace 8 is getting back near starting stack. Very nice job by the TV table dealer once again. And we have a new dealer joining us. Folds around to Carlsen with the A7 suited. And Carlsen does open up the 4,500. Jacobson reaching for chips from the hijack. Does call with the Jack 10 offsuit. Forberg getting out of the way, but Onsen, who can be active, especially on the button with a variety of hands, does have a tasty hand now with the nines. Let's see if he calls or three bets. He is reaching for chips. This does look like a three bet. Perhaps the 16,000. It is the 16,000. Bilstad folds his reg. Spite will also get out of the way. I think this will get the job done. Carlsen quickly folding. And Jacobson does not want to play his Jack 10 offsuit out of position in a bloated pot. Also folding as well, and now Onsen is over triple a starting stack after winning that hand. And Barry will be doing something from under the gun with this ace queen too strong to just fold. Let's see how much he opens for is the only question. And it's the same sizing that everybody's been using lately, up to 4,500. Carlsen and Jacobson showing up with nothing. Forberg as well will be folding. Onsen made a move earlier with 6-5. Let's see if this, maybe this is his favorite hand because he didn't immediately fold. He is facing an undergun open. A 3-bet would look super strong. But by now the players at the table understand how many gears Onsen has, which makes him a very tricky player. And it does look like for a second time he is three betting is 6-5, this time from the cutoff. To 5.5 big blinds. Now, if he didn't 3-bet, we've seen Spike call these kind of hands from positions, from all positions, including the small blind. And both him and Vold would have gotten into the action, so at least he cleared that away. Now, can Barry snip this out? It doesn't look like he will mind playing this out of position, but is he going to 4-bet, call, or fold? It doesn't look like the decision has been made yet by the Norwegian. And Barre does indeed call to bring this pot up to 27,000. Barre was unable to connect with the Jack 7-7 flop, does have backdoor hearts, but only to the queen. That's sort of irrelevant comparatively to the two overcards that he has. And Onsen continuing his aggression with just 6-5, betting out for 12,000. Can Barre sniff this out? It's awfully difficult playing this hand out of position without flopping a piece of it. Perhaps he does understand that he's ahead thus far and makes the call. And now Barre, improving to 2-pair on the ace of spade turn, does check. Will Onsen now be repping the ace, repping something stronger? Or will he be slowing down his aggression? If Barre had something like 8s, 9s, or 10s, that would be a scare card for him. But instead, this card should make Barre more comfortable. He would obviously still be behind an ace-jack, ace-seven, ace-king. But Onsen does slow it down. And now with the 7 of clubs on the board, putting 3 7s on the board, Barre with the full house. Onsen doesn't really have 7s, I say that, but he's sitting with 6-5, so I guess he could have 7s, but there's only one in the deck. So Barre should feel comfortable he has the best hand. But would he bet for value, considering not much worse than him can call, maybe a jack? Or will he try to get his opponent to bluff into him? No immediate decision has been made yet by Barre. Maybe he's decided and not acted yet. Or maybe thinking about how much is in the pot and how much he should be betting. And betting big. Perhaps if it was a little bit smaller, Onsen would raise him. But Barre only with 38,000 behind. Now still, if Onsen came over the top, it would look strong, but it's just not a hand Barre could ever fold. Onsen would have to say Barre doesn't have an ace. He could probably get him to fold the jack, but not an ace. He would be able to get him to fold those 10s, 9s, and 8s, but with 10, 9s, and 8s be betting so big on the river, turning their hand into a bluff that has some decent showdown value that could call a bet by Onsen, potentially. And Onsen can't steal away every pot, recognizes this was not one he could take away, and Barre, up to 124,000. It's been a nice display of poker by Barre, who was short at one point and now is above a starting stack. Remaining calm, cool, and collected throughout the day.
Someone would have been a setter på syv.
Carlsen and Jacobsen fold their weak holdings from early position, but let's see what Forberg does. He likes to mix it up a little bit. He does have Jack 10 off from middle position. Does fold after a little bit of thought. We can never tell when Onsen's going to try to be aggressive. This is apparently one of those times with the 10-4 suited. raising 2.5 blinds to 5,000. Gets Bill set to fold. And Spite folds his weak ace, so far so good. That could be good for Onsen as well if other players get involved, just because he had ace 4 versus 10 4. But it looks like Onsen will be able to steal. I can't see Bari defending with 3-2 even though it's suited. But it looks like I am wrong about that, as he does indeed defend. With perhaps a plan, depending on what comes out on the board. But if you're gonna play 10-4, you have to be happy to see a 10 on the flop. Less happy to see that jack to go along with it. The 5 is irrelevant. And it should go check bet fold, indeed it does, and Onsen takes down the pot. Position folds with cards that we would possibly see open from later position. Watson, who just stole one, went away with 10-4 suited, opts not to try the same with the 5-2 suited. Meanwhile, Spite has shown he likes jack-10 off. We'll try it again. This time he's the first to open rather than calling it open like he has done earlier. Folds around to our chess hero, Magnus Carlsen in the big blind, who will be defending with the best hand. And Magnus Carlsen improving the trips on the ace, deuce, ace flop will be checking like he would be just about any flop. Spite checking back, and now Spite has a Broadway gut shot draw. That would be the only way to save him. Carlsen checking again, will Spite bet after it's checked over twice to him. On the flop, Carlsen will be checking just about every flop rather than donk betting. And Spite does indeed take a stab at it. And Carlsen folds. And this may actually slow down the action rather than speed it up, because Spite did connect with that river. He did have showdown value. And it did go check, check on the river, and Carlsen picks up a much needed pot, even though it wasn't large. He's back up to 73,000. It's been quite the exciting TV table, not just because of Magnus Carlsen, but because of Onsen and a few of the other players as well. Players have been mixing it up. We did see Bilstad almost hit the rail, but his sevens did crack Bold's aces. It was a short stack, and somehow Magnus Carlsen lost a lot of chips during that pot when he tried to isolate with his ace queen before folding facing a shove. Onsen, this time actually with a hand, with the big slick, and it is suited. One of the best hands in poker. Aces and queens are definitely better, and then arguably this is hand in hand with queens. And Jacobson with also an ace king, but it is not suited.
Race.
And will be three betting. You could see how often this would be a chop pot, about 91% of the time. Let's see if Onsen calls, he would be in position, and then it could be a leveling or whether a 4-bet comes. Let's just call. So now we can see some real poker, both players having a very similar hand, and we'll see how they react to a blank deuce, eight, three flop. Jacobson with the backdoor flush draw. And Jacobson jamming here. It's going to be very hard for Onsen to call. No hearts in his hand. Both players with ace king. Incredible move here by Jacobson. It's usually Onsen the one making the moves. This time he has a move made against him. This is real poker, folks. This is why I like games like Deuce 7, No Limit, Single Draw. I feel that's one of the purest forms of poker. But it's spots like this that I absolutely adore. Onsen, though, hasn't decided yet. Does show his ace king. Let's see if Jacobson shows his ace king back. Not this time, but Onsen may see this later on the stream. He would be calling to a chop pot. He was being free rolled to some degree if runner runner hearts came. Love the action there. And this is a hand we won't see Onsen play 8-3 from under the gun. Bill said, on the other hand, did get lucky moments ago with the sevens against aces to stay alive, but is now sitting on 19 big blinds. That's not a jammable stack at this stage of the game, especially when you can't re-enter. And this tournament is just min racing from early position, despite folding a worse ace, perhaps saving himself some trouble, although he would have been in position. But I would also be folding there about 100% of the time. Let's just say 99% of the time, because maybe I misread my hand 1% of the time. Is Forberg going to defend his 5 deuce? No, he's just going to show it face up. And Bilstad should be very happy about that. And he does appear thrilled that he was able to add 5,000 chips to his stack. Any moment now, we should be learning how many, it should stop the clock, and then we'll learn how many hands each table will play out before surviving players bag chips into tomorrow's day two. As a reminder, we are watching the Norwegian Championship main event, the 2023 Norwegian Championship main event here at Card Casino Bratislava. It is one of the most pure poker events out there, a 5-day main event with two opening fights. Players have one bullet throughout, so a pure freeze out, pure poker. Very rare, especially in Europe, but even very rare anywhere around the globe. But this is how poker should be played. And Magnus Carlsen with the snowman opening to 4,500. And could be in a rough spot with Forberg waking up with the pocket rockets. Forberg not playing them slow at all, raising to 11,000 to 5.5 big blinds from the small blind. Carlsen is in position, so he can't just call if he wants, but based on his stack, he can't shove. What I don't think he will do is fold, although that would perhaps save him if he could, if he can find the right read about Forberg. But that's very difficult. Forberg should be betting with a lot more hands. And Carlsen does call. Oh my God, Magnus Carlsen here gets a dream flop of King 8-9. Flopping the bottom set here. Now if Forberg was pulling this move with Ace King, Carlsen knows that this is amazing now. Meanwhile, Forberg has even better than Ace King. He has the pocket rockets. What a dream for Magnus Carlsen, peeling off that three bet. Forberg leading out after three betting his rockets. Now, how is Carlsen going to approach this? It's still, even though it is a rainbow board, that 8-9 does connect with some of his opponent's holdings for a draw. Are we going to see a call or a raise by the chess legend Magnus Carlsen? Carlsen thinking through his options, or perhaps trying to disguise the strength of his hand. Will just call. I like this a lot. You don't want your opponent to fold. And the king of spades on the turn improves Carlsen further to a full house. He might be praying now that his opponent has ace king. Forberg, however, may actually slow down to some degree, but he can never really be folding his aces here. Not to somebody as smart as Carlsen, who could be floating and deciding what to do next. But does check, does slow down. Now it's going to be up to Carlsen to try to get more value out of this hand. There are a couple cards on the river that can actually beat Carlsen. Not just the two aces, but the two remaining kings would both give Forberg a full house, but he doesn't know what Forberg has. But even if he put Forberg on an ace-king type of hand, those cards would still apply. But instead, it's a queen of hearts on the river. Carlsen checking it back once again, disguising how strong his hand is. Let's see if Forberg thinks he's ahead. That would be the only reason why he would put more chips in. Carlsen has a little more than a pot-sized bet behind. And Forberg reaching for his chips.
18.
Betting 18,000 into a pot of 42,000. What a poker face by Magnus Carlsen. Looking a little troubled by that bet. But expect him to come over the top. Obviously now he's losing to some king-queens as well, so we'll see how he approaches it. He shouldn't be concerned so much about the king 9, king 8, but those are possibilities as well. But Forberg wouldn't have been 3-betting those, I don't believe. He's been playing fairly close to the vest, and for him to be 3-betting king queen would have been out of character for Forberg as well. So Carlsen should still feel he has the best hand here. Possibly just disguising this with the waiting time to make it appear like he would be bluffing when he jams in a stack, which is what I think he will do. I'd be shocked if he just calls. He does just call though, folks. He could have gotten more value, but still cracked Forberg's aces to get back over a starting stack. 113,000 the chess legend has now, near the end of day 1B. Does seem disappointed he didn't get more value, but did get quite nice value nonetheless after flopping a set with the snowman. Meanwhile, Forberg should feel fortunate that he didn't have to get more chips in and still has plenty of chips with players about to bag for day into tomorrow's day two. What a hand to nearly end the day with, though.
Det är ett lockbud det gör, för det var helt ärligt.
Jag har till och med på det. Det var det jag sa till det.
It's nice how much fun the players have together. The Norwegian community is one of the best around. So we're on the final four hands after this hand, and Forberg, who just had aces cracked, now waking up with the Cowboys, perhaps going to be able to get some of his chips back, hoping to get a double here, but that will all depend on how players in the blinds play. Raising it up to 5,500 now, Lawson, who has been playing fairly aggressively. He won't be doing so with trade deuce from the small blind. But what will Bilstad do with a 20 big blind stack from the big blind with queen jack? It was a fairly large, but an open as well to 5,500. Keep in mind the big blind is only 2,000, but Bilstad will defend nonetheless. Oh, it's five more hands after this. Apologies. We heard four, and now we hear five. So Bilstad checks as he would most flops, even though this one hits his range. Forberg bets, and that's good enough to get the job done. And he shows his cowboys. So ending the day with aces and kings, the aces didn't work out for Forberg after Magnus flopped the set with his snowman. And the kings, he wasn't able to get much value, but thanks to his larger betting size and a call, he was able to get some value before taking it down on the flop. It could have been worse, and he could have had his kings cracked as well. That would have been very unfortunate, but instead he does get a few of those chips back. And now it's Magnus Carlsen's turn to have a hand with ace queening. He will be opening this up. Opening to 4,500. Jacobson folds, but this could be a cooler of sorts for Carlsen. Forberg should be three betting his ace king. And we just saw Forberg get his aces cracked by Carlsen's eights and then have kings two hands later. And now with ace king suited, a beautiful hand. Does three bet the 13,000 to 6.5 big blinds near the end of day 1B. Folds back around to Carlsen. Let's see what he decides. Forberg dominating Carlsen's ace queen with ace king. Ace queen didn't work out earlier for Carlsen. There was a jam, a flat by another player with aces, and then Carlsen bet about a third of his stack, a little bit more, raised it up with ace queen, only to get jammed upon to let it go. And since then, he has rebuilt the stack thanks to his eights flopping a set and then even improving further to a full house to crack Forberg's aces. Can he suck out on Forberg again? Is he even going to be playing this hand further? Carlsen thinking things through. And it's a four bet by Carlsen to 33,000. And a jam by Forberg. And Carlsen is getting actual good pot odds, but does he want to do stack conservation or not here? He wouldn't be getting good pot odds against aces. But even against kings, his pot odds wouldn't be horrible.
Jeg har sjansen for at jeg har dem en gang til, da. Så kort. Nettopp.
Let's see if Carlsen can get out of the way. And if he calls, let's see if he can get there. We do want to see Carlsen with some chips tomorrow. No offense to Forberg, of course. A five bet jam here by Forberg after Carlsen four bet his ace queen from out of position. A little bit of table talk by Forberg there. Oh, I don't think Forberg would be too disappointed to see a fold because he's very often against the pocket pair. So probably, possibly trying to talk Carlsen into a fold here. Carlsen. Carlsen does make the call and will need some help. Meanwhile, Forberg is ahead. He will need to be sweating it to stay alive and double his stack. But it's a 144,400 chip pot. Lots of excitement to end day 1B. So far, Forberg is ahead on the 4 deuce 9 flop. No backdoors for Forberg, but Carlsen does have the backdoor to a flush if a spade comes on the turn. Now it's a queen and only a queen for Carlsen to eliminate Forberg. Otherwise, Carlsen will be short with day 1B about to end. And the 9 of spades river completes the board. Forberg breathes a sigh of relief. Meanwhile, Carlsen, who just came back after sucking out with eights against aces, is down to just 43,000, a little more than 20 big blinds.
Hadde røkket der, da...
And blinds tomorrow will be 2,500 big blind. So then Carlsen's stack will be under 20 big blinds, but there's still a few more hands to go to end day 1B.
How many hands do you have left? 4 more.
And we see on the graphic and based what was just talked about at the table, we are on the final 4 hands of the day. So anything can still happen for all the players at the table. Quite some crazy action though to end the day. And for those of you still tuned in, even though we're going to be taking a bit of a break, you will want to come back as we will have the Heads Up Championship final coming up as well. We did enjoy the semifinal matchup where Seaman defeated Espen Uden Orsted. Nothing to see here as Sveet picks up the pot with ace queen. Magnus Carlsen wishes that his ace queen worked out the same, even to win a small pot rather than losing a big one. Do love the heart by Magnus Carlsen though. Of the day. And Onsen, who has been active throughout the stream, whether he has cards or not, does have some pretty cards this time from the hijack with the ace jack suited. Opens up to 5,500. It was 4,500. I would expect Barry to fold. Let's see what it does at 55. I would expect Barry to defend, but Barry will be defending anyway with the King 9. That is a fairly strong hand, especially against how much Onsen likes to open. Nobody getting any love from the 7-7 Queen flop. Nobody having any spades in their hand either. Onsen still ahead with his ace jack. Three of hearts on the turn doesn't change anything either. And neither does the eight of diamonds on the river. And let's see if Bari can try to steal this one away, and if so, whether it would work. Both players does check, and Onsen wins the hand with ace high. on the board anyway. Both players with the pair of sevens that were on the board, but the ace kicker coming into play, beating Bari's king kicker to win one of the final pots of day 1B. We're up to our penultimate hand of day 1B with Magnus Carlsen, the chess legend, in the big blind. I think Jacobson just left his queen 10 suited. And Forberg, who has had aces, kings, and ace king in the last 10 minutes, now has jacks. The deck has hit him in the face. Unfortunately for him, he did lose some chips when his aces were cracked by Carlsen's eights, but then was able to get them back when his ace king held against Carlsen's ace queen to double up to where he is now. And does just min raise, which is very interesting. He may not have seen Jacobson's limp. I would have liked to have seen a bigger raise, but that maybe saved them because Veit waking up with queens to dominate Forberg's jacks. However, it's going to be awfully difficult for Forberg to get away from his hand, and all this should make Carlsen quickly fold his force. Whereas if Veit wasn't involved, he would have been able to get a cheap look. And Forberg deciding if he wants to claw off more than a third of his stack with the jacks.
How did ever dare to see him that? Can I show him the cards and tell him what I'm considering now?
Perhaps Forberg trying to get a read, asking if he could show his cards or tell his opponent what he has. The dealer has advised him not to, his hand would be dead. Will Forberg be able to lay down his jacks? It would be the fold of the day. It's very difficult to fold jacks pre-flop. And again, it's very difficult sometimes to play jacks in general. It's one of those hands many videos have been made about. Mostly as jokes. And does call only to see that he is one pair behind Spite's queens, and Spite may be able to end the day on the high note. He may be ending the tournament on a bad beat, but as of right now, he's in amazing shape to double up with his queens versus Forberg's jacks. And so far, the queens remain ahead on the 6-king-9 rainbow flop. The six of spades pairing the board on the turn, changing nothing for Spite. He just needs to fade two outs to double his stack, and the two of diamonds on the river is safe for Spite to double up.
50.
It's been quite the roller coaster ride with Forberg, with aces, kings, ace king, and jacks in the latter half of the final blind level of day 1B. This time he was behind and didn't get there. Meanwhile, Spite, you could see him feeling very happy that his queens held against those jacks. And we are up to our final hand of day 1B. So I'm not sure how much time I'm going to have at the end here, but I just want to remind you that we have the Heads Up Finals coming up very quickly after this. And of course, we will be back tomorrow for the beginning of day 2. It will be broadcasted live at 12:30 by the Norwegians. We'll be on a bit more of a delay doing it in English. Players will have their cards in the air at noon. Players can still enter late register before the start of day 2. This is a freeze-out event, so players that you have seen get eliminated both during yesterday's day 1A and today's day 1B will not be able to get back in the action. This is a pure poker event, poker as it should be. There's nothing worse when you eliminate an amazing player and then you see them back deep in an event only to take your chips later. I love how in this Norwegian Championship main event, once you're out, you can't get back in again. It's not about generating as much rake up as possible. It's about being as player friendly as possible. And meanwhile, we may see Magnus Carlsen chipping up at the end of the day, getting no love, gets back to half a starting stack. And thank you for everybody for tuning in. This is Jason Glatzer live at Card Casino for the Norwegian Championship main event. See you again tomorrow or in an hour or so for the heads up affair. Peace and have a good night.